بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome once again to yet another episode of our series of discussions wherein we are sharing messages of hope. And in today's episode we are going to look at the profound meaning of uttering the words Inna Lillahi wa Inna Ilayhi Raji'un whenever a loss occurs. It is possible that at the time when a loss occurs, you merely recite these words as a routine reaction. Now, this is the time for you and me to deeply ponder over its meaning, which is very profound. And in reality, these words are a profound formula for peace, solace, and comfort. Before explaining the amazing meaning, kindly recite after me once more these words sincerely from the bottom of your heart. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We certainly belong to Allah, and to Him we are bound to return. Now, ponder and think deeply. What are you really saying? Firstly, you are reaffirming that everything and everyone belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your children, your family, your friends, your possessions, and even you yourself belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence, He has the sole prerogative and right to do as He pleases and to take back whom He wants. Nobody has the right to question Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to object to His decision. And secondly, you are affirming and reminding yourself that everything and everyone, including yourself, will inevitably return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence, there is no need to become depressed when He has taken away your beloved who was always meant to return to Him. Again, you are reminding yourself that you will also be heading in that direction and you will join your loved ones sooner or later. What profound words and what an effective and beneficial treatment for your grief and sorrow these words are. These words are actually a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned that my ummah has been granted such a gift at the time of a calamity which was not given to any of the previous nations. And that is Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And this is recorded in Tabrani and Majma'u Zawa'id. Therefore, repeat these words verbally, reflect upon their meaning, and submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the depth of your heart. You will definitely enjoy great relief and comfort and solace and peace. Together with this, you will also receive immense reward and bounties from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the Quran, the Almighty Allah, after mentioning that throughout life, man will definitely be tested with some fear and hunger and loss in wealth, lives and fruits, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَّبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. That O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give glad tidings, give good news to those who are patient, those who, when a calamity afflicts them, they say, we certainly, we most assuredly, and we indeed belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to Him we are bound to return. Those are the ones upon whom there are blessings from their Rabb and mercy, and those are the ones who are on the right path. This is Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 156 and 157. So many benefits and rewards for reciting just one sentence. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Firstly, you become a recipient of good tidings or good news or glad tidings from the side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the medium of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What greater glad tidings can there be? The one giving the glad tidings is Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahamur Rahimin, the most merciful of those who show mercy. And the glad tidings are being given through Rahmatul Lil Alameen, the mercy to all the worlds, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is sufficient proof that whatever the difficulty, trial and tribulation you are undergoing, it is not a punishment, but rather a means of mercy. Secondly, you qualify as being part of the Sabirin, the patient ones, thereby becoming eligible for the tremendous reward that had been promised to them. And thirdly, you will be granted salawat, special mercies and bounties directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not through the agency of the angels, but directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And fourthly, when you utter these words, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, you will also receive rahmah, that is general mercy, that will come to you through the agency of the angels. And fifthly, you will be guided to the correct realization that Allah Ta'ala is your master, the one who solves your problems and compensates your losses. Allahu Akbar. Reflect over how merciful your Allah is. Although He had the full right to take away your loved one, He still favors you in so many ways for adopting sabr on this loss. Therefore, whenever this loss comes to mind, recite, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, from the bottom of your heart, together with reflecting and pondering over its deep meaning. May the Almighty Allah enable us to utter these words whenever a loss occurs to us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not give us any test or any problem or difficulty that we will not be able to bear. Until we meet again in the coming episode, Ja'alana Allahu wa iyyakum min alladhi